Rule number one about cutting school.
I've cut school before.
To shop. Rule number one, cutting school is fun.
That's a rule?
Rule number two, cut rarely to preserve the specialness.
Is that even a word?
Rule number three, do something culturally rewarding with your time to earn it morally.
Rule number four, you're a dork.
Wrong. Rule number four, noodles.
Noodles?
And the moment will come when composure returns. Put a face on the world, turn your back to the wall.
Hi, this is Don from Airport Plaza Jewelers, the Kiosk Presents, and we have the fantastic honor of bringing to you Emma Roberts and Freddie Highmore, the stars of The Art of Getting By. Emma, Freddie, welcome to the Kiosk Presents.
Thank you
very much.
Thanks for having us.
And I saw the trailer. Now listen, I'm a granddad, but it was a very interesting trailer. Now, would you characterize the movie The Art of Getting By as a teen movie, a coming-of-age movie, or maybe just, and this would be for Emma, a guy just can never get it quite right movie?
I'm going to use that. That's a good one. I think it's very much a coming of age, growing up kind of movie. It's takes place in that transitional stage of when you're trying to figure out who you want to be for yourself, not for everyone else, and who they want you to be. And it's great because there's adults in the movie, and they're kind of acting like children, and you have children acting like adults, and I think that everyone can really relate to that, young or old, at some point in their life.
It's that awkward transition era, huh? You know, and Freddie, let me ask you a question, too, because I think you can relate to this as a guy. Figuring out the opposite sex, I mean, guys call this mission impossible, okay? Does the film finally give us the answer?
I'm not sure there is a sort of specific answer as such, which is why I like the film, actually. It sort of shows it as it is. There isn't a sort of formula that you can follow.
Sadly, there is no answer to that.
No, but I'd say definitely the film says, you know, you have to, as you grow up, become a sort of active participant in your life and say, you know, this is a girl I love, so I'm going to go for it. This is the person I want to be in, and I'm going to act
upon
that.
You love me?
Emma, listen, I, as Sally, You always say the romance killing words, and remember what those were? We're just friends. Now, how do you account for that? I mean, how is Freddie as George not to be confused when this beautiful girl keeps saying, "Don't worry, we're just friends."
I know, I just friended him, which is just the meanest thing. No, I know, because I think Sally is really confused. I think she, as much as she wants to be something more, she also wants to stay friends, and I think she's trying to figure out things with herself, and she, in turn, is not being fair to George.
Good. Another question for you, too. I mean, when you play a role like this, too, how close of friends do you become? Like, and I've asked this for other people starring in other movies. Is this the kind of thing where you really get to know each other so well that you want to maintain the friendship even after the movie's over?
Absolutely, yeah. No, yeah. People always seem to say we have great chemistry in the film. And I think, yeah, obviously part of that comes from the fact that we got on so well off set. Yeah.
Definitely.
And everybody, every young person in Western New York wants to know, how do you break into the movies? What was your first breakthrough, Freddie? And then I'm going to ask the same thing of you, Emma.
I think that you have to a certain extent get lucky. I'd say especially as when you're younger, you know, there are so many things that can go for you or against you that it's important to keep to some extent your options open. But at the same time, when you get to a point that you've decided this is what I want to do, I think the film kind of says, you know, go for that.
Now, one more quick question too, because obviously this is a love story too, all right? Do you think it has a good universal appeal for both guys and girls? Because girls tend to have a very strong definition of romance. Guys, they're a little bit different. Emma, you can tell me about that, can't you? Guys are, you know,
yes.
They don't define romance exactly the same way. Talk to me about that a little bit.
No, I think that's what's so great about this movie is because it, as much as, you know, it is about romance and love, it is more about it in the conventional way, not the over-the-top kind of exaggerated way. It's very much how love actually is and how it's complicated and it's scary and it's great, but it can also be really, really sad.
That's good. All right, and Freddie, one more thing too. Any suggestions to the guys out there? You know, some guys hold back a little bit, don't express their feelings. Are you a little bit more in touch with your feelings after playing the part in the movie? What do you suggest to us guys? You know, I should say the younger guys out there just don't have a clue about what's on the girl's mind. How do you help them out?
That's exactly that. Yeah, you have no clue until you ask, I think. And to be honest, there's not too much to lose. I mean, There's the chance that she'll say, you know, I think we're just friends, and that's sad, but at the same time, it's better to know that. But probably the greatest chance is if there's some sort of relationship between you that is special, that she'll say yes. I think just go for it, and then, yeah, hopefully you end up with the girl.
Okay, Weston Eric, you heard Freddie Highmore. He said, just go for it, guys, okay? So that's the final word on the matter. Guys, it's been absolutely wonderful having you here. The name of the movie is The Art of Getting By with Emma Roberts and Freddie Highmore. Great trailer. I'm going to recommend everybody, all 1 million people in Weston Eric, go out and see the movie.
Thank you so much.
Seems like a lot of fun.
Thank you very much, guys,
for joining us, okay?
Thank you. Take care now.
Of course. Bye.
You bet. Bye-bye.
Want you look in the mirror and find something you've never had the courage to say before? Find what you care about, what you believe. Yeah.